the 1985 Washington State High School Track and Field Championships, brought to you by the Dairy Farmers of Washington. Milk, the natural way to get your calcium. And by SeaFirst. Stop in at any SeaFirst branch and get the personal loan you want at the low interest rate you expect.
Going to be watching Tracy Millett. She won the event, Tracy of Auburn, and a nice throw, Mike Ramos.
144.8, that's a great throw. She'll be real competitive in college with that alone.
All right, Jackie Hentges of Meade was second, but far down the line at 129.2. Congratulations to Tracy Millett, the girls' AAA discus champ. Here, Erica Wheeler of Squim, she has got to be the class of the field in the girls' javelin double A.
She looks great. She comes through the point, just hits it very nicely.
What a throw. 189 feet 7 inches. That is the third farthest throw in America this year. What an excellent throw by Erica. She gets congratulations from the second place finisher, Jill Smith of Mark Morris. 153-1. The crowd just loves it. Erica Wheeler of Squim, the state champ. Now we're going to get a look very quickly at John Quaid of Woodinville, running by here in a semifinal of the 800. We'll see him later in the finals of that event as well. Moving on to the high jump, Todd McAllister of Lewis and Clark. And he clears the bar at 6 feet 10 inches. But the man in AAA high jumping for the state of Washington is Rick Noji of Franklin.
Rick's a great jumper. I think he got a little scare at 6'10 from Todd, but he comes through here, nice curve, clips a little bit with his elbow.
Not uncommon for Rick to miss on his first jump, but we'll come back now for his second leap attempt at 7 feet. Rick Noji of Franklin.
Being the jumper he is, he comes back nice, gets his hips high and clears it. He's happy.
It's incredible to me that a young man 5'8 can jump that high, but he can do it and he wins the state title. And it's no surprise to anyone, Rick Noji wins it. And now the long jump, another event where we'll see Rick Noji, but this is Matt McPherson of Bellevue as he makes his run down the runway, hits his mark. And a good jump by McPherson, 23 feet even. But again, he has got to contend with the state's finest jumper. There's his father looking on, Rick Noji's father, watching his son in the long jump.
Rick has that European bounding style, and he comes through. He's got great speed, hits the board. Nice jump, over 23 feet.
Really extends out there. 23.25 to be exact. That good enough for the AAA Boys Long Jump Championship. So Rick Noji, a little spring in his step when he learns that he wins it. He wins the boys' AAA long jump. Now, the boys' AAA 100 finals. They're at their marks. The gun is up. Uh-oh, false start.
Steve, in Washington State competition, you only have one false start as opposed to the international rule. So he's got to be disappointed here.
Oh, he is indeed. That's Doug Rich of Lincoln High in Tacoma. So he's out of there. We'll restart again for the boys' AAA 100-meter finals. And it's a good start this time. It looked to me like Whit Finks got off on the inside. Look at Whit Finks in the yellow shorts. He looks like he's out there in front. John Gary on his hip from Garfield, but it's Whit Finks at the wire. Whit Finks wins it from Newport High, a time of 10.8. John Gary of Garfield, second, 10.83. And last year's winner, Todd Witzel of Lindbergh, third, 10.97. And today's events, we'll begin with the boys' AAA 800-meter finals. This should be a great race. Let's set the scene for you first. Chuck Gregg from Wilson High is in lane number one. Wade Ingebretson from North Central in lane two. Bob Haggard from Richland, Tri-Cities young man, in lane number three. Dan Hardebeck, Eastside Catholic, is in lane four. There's your favorite, John Quaid from Woodinville, is in lane five. Chris Warner of Clover Park in lane six. Don Jensen from Puyallup in lane seven. And in the outside, lane eight, Ryan Wick of Wilson High School. A great field for this 800-meter final.
Yeah, it looks to me that John Quaid should be the class of the field with Chris Warner right behind him. We'll just have to see how they run it. Anything can happen at 800 meters.
It can indeed. A race I never wanted to run in high school, I'll tell you that. A standing start at 800 meters. They're set, and there's the gun. So they'll move around this track, 800 meters. Now, they can make the break out of their lanes, Mike Ramos, at the 300-meter mark.
Right. This is a two-turn stagger race, and at the end of the second turn, you'll see a series of cones, and that's where they'll cut into lane one.
All right. As we look across the field here at the Lincoln Bowl, you can see that John Quaid and Chris Warner seem to be making up that stagger on the remainder of the field. They just ran out of the picture to the left. The remainder of the runners there. But at this point, it looks like a two-man race between Chris Warner and John Quaid.
It definitely looks like a two-man race. Looks like they came out awful fast. We'll have to see what it is at the 400-lap split time. But they're running away from it right here.
All right, there are the cones. Now, when they pass those cones, they can move down to the inside of the track. And look at Chris Warner. He is a big young man for running this 800 meters. He looks like Mike Ramos, a decathlete.
He's big and he's strong. We'll have to see if he can hold this kind of pace. It looks like they came through at 51.3, which at that pace is a world record. And we'll have to see how they hang on.
Well, John Quaid is one of the top two or three runners at this distance, high school runners in the entire nation, but a 51.3 is an incredibly fast time for the first 400 meters. Here they come down the back stretch. The last 300 yards of the 800-meter boys AAA final, and it's still John Quaid of Woodinville in the lead, but closely following is Chris Warner from Clover Park. They're moving into their last turn now.
Quaid looks to be tightening up a little bit. I think that 51.3 could have been a tactical error. Warner seems to be cutting the distance on him. We'll have to see how they finish.
Again, the 800 meters just grueling, but Chris Warner looking right now to be the stronger of the two. And in fact, he's making his move. John Quaid, you can see it on his face. He's pained. He's hurting at this point. There is Chris Warner, Clover Park. He's going to win the biggest upset of the meet so far. Chris Warner of Clover Park. He wins it in meet record time, 1:51.53. The big young man from Clover Park, John Quaid, has to be disappointed. He finishes a good time, 1:52.06, but he finishes in second place. We'll pick him up as they come off the last turn, Mike Ramos.
Yep, he got a little bit tight, it looks. He came out just a little bit too fast, and looks to me like Warner's just a little bit in better shape and a little bit stronger.
He does appear to be the stronger of the two right here. Chris Warner, congratulations to him, boys AAA winner. John Quaid in second, and Dan Hardebeck came up from Eastside Catholic in a time of 1:52.46. It's the girls' turn now. Time for the 1,600-meter AAA finals. The girls from all over the state of Washington, 16 of them crowding to the starting line awaiting that starter's pistol. Mike Ramos, this is a tough race, boys or girls.
Yeah, it's the last event in the decathlon, and I know how long that race is. We don't run quite as long as these girls will, but it's a tough race.
All right, I guess the girl to watch now would be Bridget Sterling from Roosevelt High. She has the fastest time in the state this year. But at this point in the race, it's tough to pick anybody out. What are you thinking now? You're running down that backstretch. You're one of these 16 girls. Are you just going to pace yourself? You want to go out and run your own race? What's going through your mind?
It really depends how they take it out. If they take it out tough, you got to stay with the pack. The big thing is you don't want to lose contact with the leader if you think you have a shot at it. And all these girls, I'm sure, do.
All these girls have coaches and teammates, I would expect, scattered around this Lincoln Bowl Stadium, shouting out split times to them, telling them where they are in the race and just how their race is going.
Typically, that is what happens at this level of competition. You're always getting split times from different places. It gets confusing, too, to the runner after a while. You don't know exactly where you are on the track a lot of times.
Mike, we talked about it at the top of the program. The fine high school track and field athletes coming out of the state of Washington. We just barely touched on the fact that the athletes here don't have the kind of weather that you need for sprinting, but certainly for distance running, miles, 1,600 meters, 3,000 meters, this weather is conducive to this kind of running.
This is great weather for this type of running. You don't overheat, and that's real important in the longer run, so the cool weather is real nice.
All right, they've completed their first 400 meters here, and the leader after 400 meters was Bridget Sterling. Her split time, 71.1. That's a pretty comfortable pace for Bridget Sterling.
Yeah, that is a real good pace. If she can hang on to that, it doesn't look like anybody's going to challenge her.
All right, we see the girls now moving down the backstretch. Bridget Sterling just about pulling away from that group. You talk about losing contact, but she appears to be moving along quite well. Moving into that turn now off the stretch. Oh, somebody stumbled right there. Who was that? Oh, and now she fell.
Yeah, looks like she got tripped. Typically, you don't have that fall in the later part of the race. It's usually in the very start at the waterfall start.
Well, that was Sophia Vicent from Snohomish. She stumbled once, and then she fell. And she was in pretty good position. So we'll check and see if there was any foul there. But right now, Bridget Sterling of Roosevelt really stretching out the lead over the rest of the pack here in the 1,600-meter AAA finals for girls. We'll come back to the girls' race here in just a moment. Now, we'll move over and check in to the boys' AAA triple jump. And there's a familiar-looking figure at the triple jump bit. He's preparing for his attempt. That's Rick Noji, who's already won in the long jump and the high jump. This is not his best event, is it?
No, it's not his best event, but he's such a great athlete that he should do well here, too. He's, he's just a natural jumper, and the triple jump's just another extension of the jumps.
All right, I guess it's basically his great natural speed that makes him a good triple jumper, right?
Yeah, he's light, and he's got the good leg speed, and he's real powerful for his size.
All right, his first jump, not a very good one up to Rick Noji standards, at least 43 feet, 11 inches. So this will be Rick Noji's second attempt at the AAA boys triple jump.
He's getting ready here. He looks like he's dead set on getting another state title. He's looking pretty good on the runway.
2-3-0.
He missed out on his hop.
Yeah, he looked like he pulled out of it a little.
Yeah, he did pull out of it. He may be feeling the pains of yesterday a little bit.
Look at his face. He's got pain written on that face. Let's watch him here in slow motion coming down the runway, and you tell us what happened.
Well, he hits the board okay, and it's on his step. His step, it looks like his ankle gave way a little bit, and he didn't complete the jump. Hopefully he's not hurt.
Well, we know that Rick Noji has had some ankle problems because of his basketball season. So we'll just wait and see. Now, the big question, will he compete in the 200 meters later on this evening? All right, so we move over from the boys' triple jump to the finish of the girls' 1600-meter AAA finals. And the girl you see in front, Bridget Sterling from Roosevelt, has led from start to finish. She's still out in front, way out in front of the rest of the pack, moving down the backstretch, going into the final turn, Mike Ramos. She looks like she's going to be a runaway winner here in 1600 meters.
She took it out very fast, and it doesn't seem that anyone's going to challenge her, but at a 71-second pace, she's running 4:44, which is a little fast. If she can hang on to it, she'll be doing very well.
Well, Bridget coming in, she was the top runner in the state, had the fastest time at 1600 meters. Now, who's this? Lisa Cork from Meade is starting to move up. Certainly, Bridget Sterling is going to have an... Look at this! Lisa Corp from Meade has come from nowhere. At the finish, she wins 1600-meter finals. Lisa Corp from Meade, and she should be happy. She could not have believed that she would have won this race the way Bridget Sterling took it out.
She took it out real fast. She had a long gap to make up. Typically, when you lose... When you lose contact like that, it's hard to make up that much ground, but she ran a great race.
Look at this, Bridget Sterling. She's out in front. She checks over her shoulder. I think she thought she had the race won, but Lisa Corp from Meade, her time now is posted 4:59.76, just runs right by her. I think she just took the steam out of Bridget Sterling's finish.
It looks to me that way.
Congratulations. One final look at Lisa Corp from Meade High School winning the state AAA 1600-meter finals for girls. She's tired, but she's happy. All right, you're looking at Lewis Sanders of Kennewick as he's getting ready for his second triple jump of the day. We're back again for the boys' AAA triple jump competition. You'll remember Rick Noji is out. He's hurt his ankle. This is Lewis Sanders of Kennewick.
Seems to have real good speed. He hits the board. He has a real nice step, and it looks to be a good jump.
He stretched out there pretty well coming off that last step into the pit. He looks pretty happy with his jump as well. Lewis Sanders of Kennewick will take another look.
He comes down the runway. He also has, looks to be good speed. Hits the board in good shape. Has a nice long step. Nice jump. He has a nice finish also.
Yeah, those legs he kind of threw out to the side just a little bit, maybe then pushing him forward as much as he would like to. But good enough for the win. Lewis Sanders of Kennewick wins it with a jump of 47 feet and 1 inch. He is the boys' AAA triple jump champion, and Jack Kincannon has him on the field.
Winning jump of 47 feet, 1 inch, 1 half inch off your best, but it was still good enough to take the win. You have to feel good.
Yeah, basically all this week we worked on short sprints, coming, getting down that runway quicker, and basically getting over the barrier, which is the long jump board. Part of the second step is to get over the long jump board in order to finish out there with a good jump.
Okay, a treat for you here. Let's take a look at your winning leap right now. And if you would, tell us what's going on in your head as you're making that approach.
Okay, as I'm coming down the runway, I'm thinking about driving off that first hop and then coming into my second step, holding my knee upward in order to get over that long jump board and then just finishing it out with a good long jump.
We'll be back for the Washington State High School Track and Field Championships, the girls' 100-meter hurdles, AA and AAA. Don't go away. So now it's the girls' AAA 100-meter high hurdles in lane number one. You're looking at Mary Kusler from Snohomish. Lane two will be Janet Otto from Mountain View. Julie Thorsland is in lane three. She's from Kentwood. Garfield's Leslie Campbell, fourth in this event last season, in lane number four. The favorite, Sandy Collins from Garfield, lane five. In lane six, Joyce Schwime from Puyallup. In lane number seven, Brenda Harding from Kamiakin. And lane eight, Carissa Peterson from Kennedy. They've been called to their marks by the starter, and the gun is up. Set. Good start by all across the board. And it's Sandy Collins. She's out in front already. Two, maybe three steps ahead. Sandy Collins in front. Joyce Schwime from Puyallup appears to be in second place, followed by Brenda Harding. But it's Sandy Collins at the tape. Hands raised in victory. Sandy Collins wins it. Joyce Schwime from Puyallup in second. Not sure on the third. Unofficial time, 14.3 for Sandy Collins. Mike Ramos, we're going to take a look at it coming over the hurdles. Tell us about Sandy's style here.
Sandy looks good. She got out of the blocks well, and she's attacking the hurdles. What you want to do is get the least amount of time in the air as possible, and she's getting her feet down and running between the hurdles, and she looks good, and she ran away with the race as a result.
She's got those nice long legs, never touched a hurdle, and she breaks the tape, the winner. Sandy Collins, UW bound.
It was a good run for you, Sandy. You got out in front and just blew them away.
That's what I was trying to do, so I wouldn't get snatched at the line like last year.
Okay, you came into this meet with the fifth best time in this event, but you took it today. You must have done some hard work.
Yeah, because I knew, you know, Joyce Swin from Puyallup, she would be on me. But in the prelims, you know, I just tried to get good time so I get a good lane and stuff for the finals.
Well, we're set to go with the girls' AAA 100-meter finals. In lane number one from Columbia River, it's Jada Neal. From Clover Park, lane number two, Tina Haskins. Amy Hodgegraff from Bothell in lane three. South Kitsap, Holly Watson in four. Fort Vancouver, Stephanie Hunter. She's the favorite, lane number five. From Rogers of Spokane, Tina Bramman in lane six. From Puyallup, Joyce Schwine, she's in lane seven. And from right here at Lincoln in Tacoma, Michelle Stanley. Off to a good start. Oh, my goodness, out of the blocks first, Stephanie Hunter. Stephanie Hunter running away with the race right now. For a second, it's a battle with Holly Watson, but out in front, Stephanie Hunter from Fort Vancouver breaks the tape. She wins it. An excellent time as well for Stephanie Hunter. As a matter of fact, a new meet record, and she has to be happy about that. Stephanie Hunter of Fort Vancouver wins it in a new meet record time of 11.95. Holly Watson from South Kitsap is second, and Joy Schwime of Puyallup comes in third. Time now for a new event here at the Washington State High School Track and Field Championships. New to the extent that it's got a new name, it's got a new hurdle height. They're calling it the boys' 300-meter intermediate hurdles. Mike Ramos, explain it.
Well, basically what they did is move the hurdles from 30 inches to 36 inches to conform to the international specifications. The next step they'll probably take in this race is probably move it to 400 meters, and then it'll be a straight conversion, so there'll be no problem that way.
All right, lane number one from Renton is Renard Coleman. To Darwin Hardy from Foss is in lane two. Jay Banks, an excellent high hurdler from Columbia River, in lane three. Richard Carey of Garfield, one of the favorites, lane number four. Here's the favorite, Darwin White. He's from Foss. He was fourth in the low hurdle event last year. He has the state's best time so far this year. Mark Phillips of Garfield is in the sixth lane. From Auburn, Pat Guerrero, the seventh lane. And finally, Kelly Soucy in lane number eight. He's from Puyallup. 300-meter intermediate hurdles. That's a long way to have to run and jump over a hurdle about every 14 or 15 steps. The gun is up right now. The boys coming to rest in the blocks. Good start.
Looks like he's coming out. It's going to be hard to say. Looks like 14, 15 steps. So if he can hang on to that, he should pull through.
This is an event, of course, that Edwin Moses has made famous around the world. But as they start to close up that stagger around the backside, it looks like Richard Carey of Garfield and Darwin White of Foss. Richard Carey of Garfield now in the middle of your track. He appears to be coming off the turn in the lead. Next to him, hard to tell at this point, Three-man race, two Garfield, one from Foss. It's going to be Garfield at the wire. Mark Phillips comes up on the outside in lane number six. Mark Phillips nips Darwin White of Foss and his teammate Richard Carey, also from Garfield. Unofficial time, 38.1. Mark Phillips, not exactly the favorite coming in here, and as a matter of fact, he's not in the lead coming off the turn. His teammate is Richard Carey, who's leading going over this hurdle. But now watch on the left, as you see from Foss, Darren White coming up, and now Mark Phillips at the wire.
Mark Phillips, a great run for you. Tell us about the finish. That's where you got it.
Me and Darren White were coming in at a tie, almost, it seemed like. And there was with us was Richard Carey on the left. And I knew if I could stretch that last hurdle on the left, on my left leg, and get it over my right leg, I'd be able to take it off. Fortunately, I got it. I was able to stretch it.
We'll be back with more of the Washington State High School Track and Field Championships right after this.
You may think these nutritious natural.
To the Washington State High School Track and Field Championships. Time now for the boys, AAA 200-meter finals, and this should be a great race. Lane number one from Shadle Park, Ron Fabian. Chris Holyfield, lane number two out of Bellevue. Whit Finks, who won the 100 meters earlier from Newport. Whit Finks is in lane number three. Lane number four, Tim Sullivan, with the fastest time in the state this year, 21.42 out of Pasco. Lane number five already has won two state titles, the long jump and the high jump, Rick Noji from Franklin. Lane number six, Doug Rich out of Lincoln, right here in Tacoma. Lane number seven from Lindbergh, last year's straight AAA 200-meter champion, Todd Witzel. And in lane number eight from Garfield, John Gary. This should be a great race.
This should be a great race. Fink should have the good early speed coming out of the blocks, and I think it's going to be Sullivan and Noji at the wire.
Good start by everybody. We'll see how well Noji's ankle hangs on. Look at Noji making up the sprint on the curve.
Well, he made up that stagger like they're standing still.
My goodness. Now let's see if that ankle will hold up. They're coming around the turn, down the straightaway. Right now it's Rick Noji and Tim Sullivan. It's Rick Noji and Tim Sullivan. Rick Noji will win his third state title, 200 meters. Rick Noji followed by Tim Sullivan of Pasco. And Noji pushes his team, Franklin, yet further. 10 big points for Franklin and Rick Noji. Well, now let's check in with our colleague Jack Concannon and a very happy winner in the boys' 200 meters.
Rick Noji, no question about it, all smiles right now. A little while ago we talked to you, you weren't real happy, a little down, but right now you got to be a happy young man.
I am, definitely. I was all worried about it. I was nervous. I haven't been this nervous since I think the first time I ran, so I feel pretty good.
You obviously had some kind of energy bottled up because you hit that first curve and you took off. What was going through your mind at that point, and did you expect to have that kind of a start?
Well, I knew that I should have that kind of start because I'm pretty good out the blocks and I ran the corners pretty good. And plus, if I had any chance of winning it, I'd have to get him out of the corner since I'm a pretty weak straightaway runner. So I was pretty pleased with the curve.
Does your foot feel okay right now?
Oh, it feels good. My legs are tight, kind of tired.
One question Steve Rabel wants to know, get an answer to, and that is, how does somebody as small as you do the things that you normally bigger people do?
I don't know. Inherited, I guess, natural.
Okay, well, I'm sure you'll keep doing it at UW. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Great day.
Much. Thank you.
I don't know if this race, the AA 200 meters, can be any more exciting, but we'll see. From Hoquiam, Todd Hoynes in lane one, Burlington Edison, Brad Sutton in two, Alan Lovelace from Lakeside three, Olaf Mack, Centralia four, Scott Craig from Shelton in five, from Peninsula in lane six, Dale Moss, Cole Michael Bust from Kelso in seven, and from Monroe, Tim Kyle in lane number eight. The gun is up. 200 meters, boys AA finals. Another good start. See who makes up the stagger here, Mike Ramos.
Looks like Lovelace in three has made up a big stagger, and there in lane five also is Scott Craig. Looks like he's doing really well.
Alan Lovelace coming in with a good time of 22 flat, but now he's dropping back. Look at big, tall. Is that Dale Moss stretching it out? Can't really tell. No, lane number five from Shelton, Scott Craig. Scott Craig is the winner unofficially in a time of 22. Right now down the backstretch, looking pretty good.
Looks like Spanaway Lake's made up a lot of ground so far. We'll have to see what he looks like coming through the final turn.
That's right, a 400 meters is never over till you get back to the start finish line, and it's very easy to tie up on that final turn coming down the straightaway. But as it looks right now, Spanaway Lake, well, maybe he is tying up just a little bit. Rainier Beach and Lake Stevens in the middle of the track looking pretty good right now.
Fife is far behind, and if they want to win this meet, they're going to have to catch up to Centralia.
So out in front is Spanaway Lake. Their man ran his first leg in 50 flat. Spanaway Lake really moving out down that backstretch.
Looks like Centralia is about 8 or 10 meters in front of the Fife runner, and he's going to have to catch him.
So again, that's really for the team championship back there, and Fife, the second runner for Fife, seems to be really dropping back. But we'll keep our eye on the lead runners right now. That's Spanaway Lake out in front, but now he's being challenged. Spanaway Lake being challenged, coming up the front straightaway by Rainier Beach. And Rainier Beach is going to come in just a little bit ahead. Rainier Beach moving into the turn on top. Boys double A, 1600 meter relay.
The Fife runner made up all the distance on the Centralia runner, and now here comes Centralia right back. It's going to be a battle.
As they move down the back straightaway, it's Rainier Beach now being challenged again by Spanaway Lake. Rainier Beach and Spanaway Lake, they've been battling the entire race. Again, as we told you, Fife and Centralia. As I look back, the Fife runner is starting to move up as he goes into the turn just a little bit. So now it's Rainier Beach. Lake Stevens is coming on. Lake Stevens has moved ahead. So Lake Stevens takes the handoff for the final leg. It's Lake Stevens, Rainier Beach, and Spanaway Lake. 1, 2, 3. They're far ahead of the pack.
Fife's dropped all the way to the rear of the pack. If he doesn't make up the ground, I think they're in trouble as far as the state crown goes.
We'll tally the team totals at the end, but we're going to watch this final leg of the most exciting 1600 meter relay. It's Spanaway Lake, Rainier Beach, and Lake Stevens, and now Rainier Beach. Rainier Beach, Spanaway Lake. Rainier Beach coming to the head of the straightaway. They're in front, they're on top, stretching it out. Lake Stevens in second, Spanaway Lake in third. Running away, Rainier Beach with the 1600 meter relay, boys double A. This broadcast is made possible under rights granted by the Washington Interscholastic Activities Association, and any use or rebroadcast of this program without the expressed written consent of the WIAA is prohibited. Now, time for the boys' 1600 meter relay AAA competition. And actually, it's all but sewn up for the Garfield boys, but we're going to run the race anyway. 4x400 meter relay. Richland will be in lane number one. Lane number two finds Puyallup. Lane three, Clover Park. Wilson, lane number four, Garfield. Lane number five, Shadle Park is in six, Foss in seven. And rounding out the field, lane number eight is Meade. So the starter's going to bring them to the blocks for this, the boys' AAA 1600 meter relay. Final event for the boys in the AAA competition tonight. Good start. And Garfield once again, Garfield's leadoff man, making up the stagger on lane number six. That's Shadle Park, and moving down the backstretch. And so at this point, it looks to be Garfield. Now, Mike Ramos, these runners have to stay in their lanes all the way through this first lap, through the first exchange, correct?
That's correct. Looks like Garfield's out in front, and they should probably hold it. So they'll stay in their lanes. There won't be any jockeying for positions until the next lap.
All right, Foss in lane number 7 appears to look pretty good coming off of the turn, as does lane number 3. That's Clover Park. So it's Clover Park, Garfield, and Foss.
Clover Park had a good preliminary time, too, and I think they're going to be the ones to push Garfield.
Well, Garfield in second place as they go into the turn, but now the second runner for Garfield stretching it out past the Clover Park runner. Clover Park in the green shorts and the green striped top. The familiar purple and gold for Garfield. And they're moving out down that backstretch, but it looks like the pack is starting to close in just a little bit on Garfield.
I think the Garfield runner went out a little faster than he wanted to, and now they're going to start to catch him a little bit, I believe.
Always a most interesting event and a most exciting event because it is one of the final events in a track meet. And so here is where the team can win or lose a team title. Now, in this case, Garfield pretty much has the boys' AAA championship sewn up. Garfield in the lead, coming into the exchange now. Third leg runner pulling away. There's the exchange. It's Garfield, Clover Park in second place.
Should be between Garfield and Clover Park.
Now, coming up on the outside, closing just a bit. But still, Clover Park on top. You get an idea of just how tight this competition really is. All the runners moving down the backstretch. Garfield still in the lead.
Walls for Garfield had turned in a 49.9 lap split time, and that's really good because he's an 800-meter runner as well.
An excellent time for that second leg, 49.9. So Garfield's third leg, struggling just a little bit. But he's pumping hard, coming down, handing off the baton.
Garfield dropped back a little bit. Clover Park's taking it out.
Garfield, though, at Garfield coming back on the backstretch. Foss passing the man from Foss is Garfield looking very relaxed.
The man from Foss took it out a little bit too fast, I think, and now he's going to pay for it as Garfield is going to open it up. Here comes Clover Park.
Clover Park coming back, fighting, battling back into second place. Let's see if Garfield can hold him off. It's Garfield and Clover Park coming down the final stretch. Garfield and Clover Park. AAA boys, 4x400. Garfield wins it. The state champs. Garfield boys, AAA, 1985. Now let's go down to the field. Jack Kincannon and the boys' AAA state champions coach from Garfield, Fred Beckwith.
So tell me, Fred, is it good the second time around?
It's even better the second time around.
What do you feel was the key to the victory tonight? Just the overall team depth, or what do you feel was the key?
Well, I think we just got outstanding athletes, and we got some great coaches that are assisting me, and hey, they do the motivating, and we do a lot of teaching.
How much does this help your program, coming back to back championships, having those and helping the kids just come out? You're going to get a lot of kids because you've won 2 years in a row?
Well, in Seattle, we don't have open enrollment, but hopefully a few kids will come our way.
Okay, congratulations and good job.
Thank you.
Well, you see there the victorious AA girls from Rainier Beach. Let's go down to Jack Kincannon and their happy coach.
Larry Moore, are you clapping for the girls? You have to be proud right now.
I am. I'm proud of them. They worked hard all year, and I'm just proud to see them get what they deserve.
What is a feeling right now? What, as a coach, after all the countless hours of work, and you get the victory, what's it like to be on top?
Well, what can you say? You know, this is what you work for all year. And the kids have been dedicated, and they've worked hard all year. And I'm just really happy for them because they are the ones that got out on the track and ran the races to be number one.
Okay, great. Larry, thank you very much for your time, and I'll let you go get with the girls.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
And so, as this Saturday evening draws to a close, the Washington State High School Track and Field Championships are history, and we crown the winners, the AA girls. Rainier Beach wins it, going away with 70 big points. In second place, Shorewood with 38 points. Third place in state this year, 34 points goes to Stanwood. We move on to the girls' AAA titleists. Garfield for the fifth consecutive year, 78 points for the Garfield Bulldogs. Kamayakin is in second place with 46, and Fort Vancouver finishes third with a total of 39 points. The big title matchup of the evening turns out to be a tie. The boys' AA competition ends in a tie between Mount Si and Fife. It came down to the 4x400-meter relay. 33 points apiece, they tie for first place. In third place is Bellingham with a total of 30 points. And winning their second consecutive boys' AAA crown, the Bulldogs of Garfield, coached by Fred Beckwith. 65 points for Garfield in first place.